हाय एवरीवन, शौर दिस साइड। आई होप आप लोगों ने सारी वीडियोस देखी होंगी मेरी, जो मैंने लेह लद्दाख एंड जम्मू कश्मीर वाले नॉर्थ सर्किट के ऊपर बनाई है। सो उसी के रिगार्डिंग आज कुछ टिप्स मैं शेयर करने जा रहा हूँ रिलेटेड टू द टू ऑप्शंस दैट यू हैव टू गो टू ले। ओके, सो आइए उसी के बारे में स्टार्ट करते हैं। सो सबसे पहले तो दो रूट्स हैं वहाँ जाने के, एक है थ्रू दिल्ली श्रीनगर एंड फ्रॉम श्रीनगर टू ले, ओके, एंड सेकेंड है फ्रॉम दिल्ली टू मनाली एंड देन फ्रॉम मनाली टू ले। अब इसमें जो मेन चैलेंजेस आते हैं और जो जो चीज़ें यू नो आपको ध्यान रखनी होंगी, सो आई टेक केयर ऑफ दैट एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आई प्लान एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आई एडवाइज यू वॉट टू डू एंड हाउ यू शुड प्लान योर ट्रिप इफ़ यू आर प्लानिंग टू गो बाई एनी ऑफ दीज टू रूट्स। ओके, सो स्टार्टिंग विद द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन विच विल बी द दिल्ली मनाली ले हाईवे। Okay, so if you start from Delhi, then the first stop that you can take is either at Manali or at Jispa, depending on you how you would like to travel or how how much distance you want to cover on one particular day. My advice in that case would be, you know, don't stretch too much, because you know it's going to be a very long and a very very hectic drive. So you know it's better that you provide ample rest and you take good sleep, so that you know you are in a good state to drive, because you know you need proper attention in this particular route. Now I'll break the whole route of Delhi to Leh for your better understanding, as well as I'll also display a map so that you know you are very much familiar with what I'm talking about. So let's start for Delhi to Leh route via Manali. So the route is Delhi to Manali, then Manali to Jispa, then Jispa to, you know, you can go to Tandi. Tandi is a very important place because there is the last fuel pump that you will be getting, which is of Indian Oil. After that, the petrol pump would be there in Leh itself. So in between, you will be having no petrol pumps. So you have to take care of the fuel. Make sure that you get your tanks refilled at this place. If the tank capacity of your car is, you know, not that great, then, you know, you can take a jerry can of say around 20 liters. That will be more than enough, and I think that's on a precautionary note that I'm talking about. After that, after Tandi is Zingzingbar. After Zingzingbar is Baralacha, then Sarchu, followed by Ghata Loops, then Nakila Pass would come, then Lachungla Pass would come, then Pang would come, after which Murid Plains will be there, after which you will get Tanglangla Pass, and after that you will be getting Roomstay, and then you would finally be reaching Leh. So if I talk about breaking up of this particular route, day one should ideally be from, you know, Delhi to Manali, because from Delhi to Manali would be taking around 13 to 14 hours. So if you start early from Delhi, say around 5:30 or 6 a.m., probably by around 8-ish or, you know, 8:30, you would be reaching Manali, and you could have an early dinner, and you know, you can go to sleep, because next day would be a drive, though that the next day's drive can be short. Okay, now it depends on you. So once you have reached Manali, then you have two options to go further. Okay, now one is through the Atal Tunnel that is there after Manali, and the other one is through the Rohtang Pass. Now if you want to cover Rohtang Pass, then you can go through the Rohtang Pass route, though this will take say around 2 to 2.5 hours of your time more when you compare it with the Atal Tunnel side. The Atal Tunnel is approximately a tunnel of 9 kilometers, which shortens the distance between Manali to Jispa by say around 60 to 65 kilometers, and it saves a time of around 2 to 2.5 hours. The road is also in good condition. Talking about all the route from Delhi till say Jispa, the roads are in good condition. You can easily drive, there's no issue, and the roads are quite broad, so you won't be facing any difficulties over here. And once you reach Jispa, now after reaching Jispa, I would advise you to take a night stay at Jispa, though the drive between Manali to Jispa would be for say around 2 hours to 3 hours at max if you take the Atal Tunnel. And why I am asking you to stop at Jispa is because, you know, the body needs to acclimatize also, because slowly the altitude is also increasing. Say Manali would be around 7,000 feet and Jispa would be at around 10,500 feet. So on an average, if we talk about, then the human body is capable of adjusting till 8,000 feet on its own. though it's not necessary that everyone would be facing acute mountain sickness or any issues related to breathing or maybe nausea or any kind of such things. But in most of the cases, you might feel any of the symptoms. And the most common symptoms of acute mountain sickness once you reach this part starts from, you know, having a mild headache to feeling dizzy to, you know, feeling, you know, you're not feeling hungry. Then in the night, you might have some breathing difficulties, a mild breathing difficulty if you face acute mountain sickness. So to avoid that, you know, I would advise you to reach Jispa early, say around 10 or 11 a.m. And you, so for that, you need to leave Manali by 8 a.m. and you reach Jispa by 11 a.m. Once you reach Jispa, just relax, just spend your day over there. Just let your body acclimatize at 10,500 feet. Okay. Because for that day, for body, that will be a good altitude increase. Okay. Ideally, it is told that after 8,000 feet, you should gradually increase your altitude for your body when you rest by 1,000 feet. Okay. So this will be slightly, manageable also for your body. You won't be exerting too much of the pressure on your body to adjust as per the new climatic conditions. Now after Jispa, you can take a hot over there. Next morning you have to wake up really early, say around at 4-4:30, and make sure that you start your journey from Jispa at around 5:30 or 6 being the maximum time. Don't delay by even 10 minutes after 6. Reason is because this day I would recommend you to drive from Jispa to Leh. This is going to be a long day, and on this day there would be many challenges that you would be facing, from very high altitude passes to roads which are not roads. So you have to take care of everything and every aspects. Say I'll take a baseline of 6 a.m. that you leave Jispa by 6. So once you leave Jispa, then there are many more locations that would be coming on this route. So first is Tandi. As I was talking earlier, this is the place where the last fuel pump exists on this route till Leh. So in that case, I would advise you to get your tanks filled at Tandi, and don't waste your time at this place, because that won't be good. Overall, the drive from Jispa till Leh would be around 12 hours, and earliest would be 10 hours, depending on the road situations and depending on the condition and depending on the number of stoppages that you take. Okay. Also, one more thing, while you travel on this route, please ensure that you have chocolates, you have biscuits, maybe glucose biscuits, they are the best. Then you could have energy bars. Actually, these helps. Okay. And just to avoid any dizziness or any mountain sickness that might hit you on this drive, it is advisable. I mean, this is a very generic thing which I also encountered on my route, and I was told by a local for that. So you could take garlic and you could take ginger, and don't chew it, just put it in your mouth and keep driving. That's kind of a natural blood dilator, so that will help you to help your body. I mean, the blood will be thin, and the oxygen supply would be enough in the body, even if the oxygen is not there in the atmosphere for your body. So this will buy in more time for your body to adjust to the new circumstances. Now, once you start your drive after Tandi, then you would be reaching Zing Zing Bar. This is a cafeteria kind of a thing, wherein you could just stop by for a cup of coffee or a cup of tea, which is being managed by BRO, which is the Border Road Organization. And after that, the next point would be Baralacha Pass. Now again, Baralacha Pass would be at an altitude of say around 15,600 to 16,000 feet approximately. Okay. So this is again a very high altitude pass, because at just by 10,500 where you are staying, the very next moment, within few hours, you would be at almost 16,000 feet. Okay. The only advice from my end would be, don't stop at the peak or at the pass, because there is, the altitude would be maximum. If you really want to stop and have a few photos being clicked, I would advise you to descend from the pass, and then you can stop at say around, after driving 5 or 10 odd kilometers, you can stop over there. Then you can relax, because there the altitude would slightly decrease, maybe from 15-16,000 feet to say around 13 to 14,000 feet. Okay. And after Baralacha Pass, you would be reaching to Sarchu. talking about the road conditions from Jispah till Sarchu, the conditions are not good. You might face boulders, you might face rocks, pebbles. There is slush on the road. There can be ice. There can be water crossings. And there's one Pagalnar also in between. So if you leave early from Jispah, the water flow in this particular nala would be less. So that would help you, you know, to avoid any mishappenings or avoid any damage to your own vehicle. Okay. After this, after Baralacha and once you reach Sarchu, after Sarchu you would be going to Ghata loops. Now this is a loop of 21 hairpin bends, wherein this ends at Nakila Pass, which is again at an altitude of say around 16,000 or 15,500 feet. Okay, so you know, overall you will be driving at a very high altitude on this particular route. After which, you know, you would be going to Lachungla Pass, and it is also at 16,600 feet. The road from Nakila Pass to Lachungla Pass is okay, you know, it's patchy. So in places you would be getting good roads, and in places you would be getting boulders and rocks also. So you have to drive very carefully. The roads are very narrow in this place, so it is good if you have a good driving experience of your vehicle, and you know all the edges and corners of your vehicle, you know, because the roads are really narrow after this. So after this, you know what, there are 2-3 things more that you have to take care of. Once you cross the Lachungla Pass, then you reach Pang. Okay, so Pang is a place where usually people take a break, and you can have good lunch over at this place, because you know this has many good restaurants and many good rest houses also. Though the altitude at Pang is around 14,000 feet, which is, you know, I would not advise you to stop or stay or spend a night at this place, because again the altitude sickness and the less amount of oxygen would kick in at the night. Then once you cross Pang, you would be reaching Moray Plains. Now this is the place where most of the shootings of film and the most of the scenic Ladakh which you see, wherein there is a straight road, butter smooth road with mountains on both sides and clouds in the sky with clear, you know, with a great view all around, panoramic view. This is the place where, you know, most of the videos for Ladakh are being shot by various filmmakers also. So this is a drive of say around 40 kilometers, which will lead you to the next point, which is Tanglangla Pass. Now Tanglangla Pass is at an altitude of 17,500 feet approximately. So this again is even more higher than the other passes. So you have to make sure that you don't stop in between, and you don't stop at the peak for not more than 2-3 minutes, or at max 5 minutes, not more than that, you know, because at this place the oxygen is really, really thin. So, you know, you have to make sure that, you don't do any rigorous activities, and you better avoid any exertions for your body at this pass specifically, okay? Chances of seeing snow at this place is maximum when you compare to all other passes on this route. So, after crossing Tanglangla, you would be reaching Rumste. So mainly, you know, Tanglangla is called as the gateway to Ladakh, and after you cross Tanglangla, the entry towards Ladakh starts. Okay, so the first city that you would be encountering in Ladakh would be Rumste, then Shyok, and post that you would be reaching Leh. Okay, talking about the road conditions after Sarchu, so from Sarchu to Baralacha to Ghata Loops to Nakila to Lachungla, the road condition is fine. After Pang, the road conditions are very good, and this would be there till Leh. Okay, so once you cross Pang and you reach Moray Plains, the roads would be fit and fine. You can easily drive on these roads, so just relax, drive, and reach your place safely. Okay, this is about the Leh route through the Delhi Manali highway. Okay, now coming to the second route, which is the Delhi Srinagar route. Okay, so if we talk about this particular route, then there are 2-3 things that you have to, you know, ensure that there is not a problem. So first of all, I'll take you through the route. So from Delhi you go to Jammu, from Jammu you go to Srinagar, from Srinagar you go to Sonmarg, then from Sonmarg you go to Zozila Pass, after which you can see the Kargil War Memorial, then you can reach Kargil, after which you go towards Namikla Pass, after which is Magnetic Hill, followed by Gurudwara Pathar Sahib, and then eventually you reach Leh. Okay, there is a Hall of Fame also in Leh, which you can see while coming from this route, which is just on the outskirts of Leh. Okay, So talking in detail, Delhi to Jammu is a busy route. Okay, so there would be traffic, there would be trucks on this route. The road conditions would be good. The only issue would be when you cross the Nashri Tunnel. That's again a tunnel of around 9 kilometers. So you have to ensure that you know you go there early morning, because again there is a lot of jam on this route because of trucks deployed. Okay, so you know, in this particular tunnel you can easily waste around 1 to 2 hours depending on when you reach this place. So after this, once you reach Srinagar, you have to ensure that, you know, just before going to Srinagar, have a look whether there's political stability or not at this place. Because, you know, sometimes curfews and, you know, lockdowns or maybe barricading is being done by police as well as the army to ensure the stability in the valley. So just, you know, just have a look at that whether that aspect is okay or not. Then travel to Srinagar. So on this route, I'd advise you, if you can reach from Delhi to Srinagar on one day, this will be a long drive, but the road conditions are good. Except the Nashri Tunnel patch, the entire road is very good. Okay, so once you reach Srinagar, stay over there, leave early morning from Srinagar. Now this day you can you can start your day from Srinagar, and then you can go to the first point, which is Sonmarg. Sonmarg, you know, it has glacier, Thajivas glacier. So all of these things are covered in my video, which is in, so you can have a look at that, and you can get a feel of that. So in Sonmarg there is Thajivas glacier, which is the main USP. From here many rivers originate, so you can have a good view of that. You can go there through horses. So approximately this will consume around 3 hours of your time. So leave Srinagar early by around 6 a.m. reach Sonmarg by around 8 a.m. take a horse to Thajivas glacier and come back to the same point, wherein you'll be parking your car in most of the parking lots which are there, which are free of cost. So your car would be safe. There will not be any issue with your car or with the parking or with the safety of your vehicle. So you can easily park your car there, then go, and then come back by say around 11:30ish or 12ish at max, not later than that. After this, then you cross Sonmarg, and then you go ahead to Zozila Pass. Now once you go ahead of Sonmarg, the road conditions again depreciate. Now what happens is, the whole route of Zozila Pass is not in a good shape, and it's still being constructed. There's a tunnel work also which is being going to bypass Zozila Pass. So you know, you will be encountering bad roads on this particular patch, and this will be say around for 30 kilometers or at max 40 kilometers. So, and also landslides are a frequent occurrence in this particular 30 to 40 kilometers of patch, because of which roads might be closed. So you might have to wait till the time the Border Road Organization comes and clears the road. Okay, so once you cross Zozila Pass, then you can directly go to the Kargil War Memorial. Now Kargil War Memorial is not in Kargil, okay, it is in Dras, and to be precise, it is in the foothills of the Tololing Peak, from where you can see Tiger Hill as well as the Tololing Peak. So these two were the main peaks during the Kargil War of 1991, which India won. And for that, I mean, once you go there, you'll actually get goosebumps. You know, you can actually see what the army has done and how, you know, they have protected the terrain which is over there, because that terrain is something very, very different from what we, you know, pursue when we talk about mountains or hill stations, or we talk about good tourist destinations. That will completely change your mind, and the view is just amazing from both the routes. Once you go, you know, the view is amazing. I mean, every 30 kilometers the landscape keeps on changing, and you know, you will take n number of photographs on this route. So you know, accordingly take a DSLR or maybe an action camera or your phone with good memory, because you know, at that time you will be needing it. Now so after you cross the Zozila Pass and you go to the Kargil War Memorial, so the distance between Sonmarg, the place from where you came down after seeing the glacier, till Kargil War Memorial would be around 4 hours to four and a half hours at max. So by 4:30 you would be reaching the Kargil War Memorial, which is in Dras. You will be needing 1 hour at this place to see the war memorial, and by 5:30 you can leave from Kargil War Memorial. Talking about the parking and everything, there is a parking, a paid parking is here, but your car would be safe. You can easily park your car over there and go and see the Kargil War Memorial. There is no entry fee for this. You just need to give in your details of the vehicle and the number of people that you are accompanying with, You can easily see, and if you go to Kargil War Memorial, do see the Hall of Fame which is there. So you can see what the Hut of Remembrance is and how it looks like over there. After that, from Dras or the Kargil War Memorial to Kargil would be around 2 hours. So you can take a halt at Kargil, and by around 7:30 you'd be reaching Kargil. Okay, take a halt over there. Kargil is also at an altitude of 9,000 feet. Okay, so as I earlier mentioned about the oxygen content and everything, you have, you know, this will be a good pit stop after Srinagar, which is again at a normal height of around 8,000 feet approximately. Okay, so reaching Kargil would be 9,000 feet. This will be a gradual incline for your body. After Kargil, then next morning you can start early from Kargil. From Kargil to Leh would be, if you don't stop anywhere, would take you around 6 to 7 hours. Okay, but there are 2-3 points that you can see on the way to Leh, and you can cover them while going to Leh. Okay, so the next morning you start from Kargil. The first thing after you know, once you start from Kargil is the Namikla Pass. Okay, Zozila Pass was at 12,000 feet approximately. Okay, and the Namikla Pass is also approximately around 12,000 feet itself. Okay, Zozila might be around 11,500, and this is at 12,000 feet. Okay, so once you compare the passes as compared to the passes which are there on the Delhi to Manali route, the passes over here are having a less altitude, and the places where you would be staying would be also having a less altitude. Okay, so gradually your body would be acclimatized in a much better way if you take this route to reach Leh. Okay, so you start your journey from Kargil the next day. The first pass that you would be encountering would be Namikla Pass, which would be at around 12,000 feet. After that, you go to Gurudwara Pathar Sahib, which is also situated at an altitude of 12,000 feet, which is very high. And you can go, and if you would like to visit this place, you can surely visit it. It's completely being managed by the Indian Army, and they take care of everything. And after this, then the next point that would come on your route, just say around 10-15 kilometers ahead of Pathar Sahib, would be the Magnetic Hill. So, you know, this is a Cyclops Hill. What happens here is, you know, you get an illusion that the road ahead is inclined, and it's steep incline. Okay, and you can park your car in neutral gear and the car starts moving ahead. Okay, so this is more of an illusion which you have. So in actual, the roads are downwards, but because of the surrounding and high mountains and the road which is straight ahead, it looks like, you know, that there is an incline in front, and the car on itself is ascending the incline. So yeah, you can have few photos clicked over here, and you can enjoy at this place. After this, you can go to the Hall of Fame, which is just on the outskirts of Leh, near the Leh airport. This is also a very good place wherein all the vehicles and all the equipments of the army are being showcased, which are being used or which have earlier been used in the war with various neighbors. So, you know, you can have a look at that, after which you can reach Leh. So if you start from Kargil at say around 8 a.m, you can reach to Gurudwara Pathar Sahib by approximately I think 12. And if you spend 1 hour over there and then you start your journey for Magnetic Hill, you can reach there by I think 1:30. After that, 30 minutes would be enough at Magnetic Hill. So if you start your journey from Magnetic Hill at 2, you can reach the Hall of Fame by around 4 p.m. That will again take 1 hour at Hall of Fame. So at by 5, you'll be free from these three places on your way. After which, you know, you can go and take your stay in Leh. Okay, so this is about the two routes that that's there for reaching Leh if you plan to self drive or if you plan to go by road. So that's it in this particular video from my end. If you do like the content, and if you do like my videos, I'll be really happy if you could like, share and subscribe on my channel. And I'll be putting up more videos, you know, related to the travel and related to my suggestions. And I hope it helps any of my colleagues or any of my friends. You know, I'll be more than happy if that works. And do feel free to, you know, ask any questions about this particular route or terrain. So I'll be making up more videos on various places which I cover. And please feel free to write your queries in the comment section. So that's it in this video from my end. Thank you. Stay safe, and wishing good health to everyone. Bye.